Hey guys, it's EDDBUD here. By viewer request, I have one of my famous versus videos for you. Today I'm going to look at the New Balance FuelCell Rebel versus the Hoka Oneone Carbon X. So lots and lots of people have been asking me, Ed, can you please compare the FuelCell Rebel against the Carbon X? They're both carbon plate shoes, slightly different implementation of that carbon plate, but that aside, they're both available. They're both kind of in the same price range, so here's a comparison. The FuelCell Rebel rocks in at about £120. I managed to pick these up for quite a bit less than that, around about £80. I was very lucky. And that Carbon X comes in at around about £160, if you can find it. So a bit of a difference in terms of price, but there's lots of differences in terms of the fit and the features of these shoes. So the upper of these two shoes has some quite notable differences. The Hoka Oneone Carbon X has this engineered sort of mesh style upper. It's very, very thin, very, very flexible. There's a slightly thicker area just at the very front of the shoe where your toes would come in. And it's also kind of built up with this stitching around the back of the shoe to provide a bit of support. So that upper is very light, it's very flexible and breathable. The shoe's got a quite old school lacing system really. They haven't gone for anything too outlandish or wacky, just old school lacing does the job well. That short tongue here doesn't protrude too much up the ankle, didn't cause me any kind of rubbing, anything like that. Although it does have that weird red mark. Has anyone else got that? If you've got this shoe and you've got any weird red kind of marks appearing, please let me know. I personally found the Carbon X quite roomy in the toe box. I read all sorts of different reviews of this shoe all over the internet. Lots of runners have just had such differing views and opinions on this shoe. Some people really love the fit, some people just don't like it at all. I personally found it a great shoe. This is one of my favorite shoes of the year so far. Roomy in the toe box, fit around the heel was really good. I found no slipping at all once the shoe had started to break in a little bit. This is a shoe I think that you do need to break in somewhat. Lots of discussion recently on some of the forums actually about shoes. Do you need to break them in? I think some you do, some you don't. I found the Vaporfly series, the 4% and the Next Percent, just really didn't need much breaking. I don't really feel that you need any on those shoes, whereas this one certainly, I think it needed about 20 to 30 miles to really break it in and mellow out that midsole. Ooh, that sounded nice, mellow out that midsole, ma. Certainly after those miles, it became less of a rigid shoe. Still can't bend it, need to do some weight training. The New Balance FuelCell Rebel has a knit style upper, quite a bit different to that on the Carbon X. It feels a little more coarse, though it's still rather soft. It has this kind of more elasticy kind of section here, quite similar to the Zoom Fly 3, I guess, but it's nowhere near as heavy. There's a thin liner that kind of envelops the foot inside the shoe. It's really quite a comfortable fit. I find it really, really nice once it's on. You don't really need to lace up the shoe that much to get a good lockdown. That knit material is very light, it's very flexible. I find the fit of the knit on this shoe, what's going on with rhymes today? Everything's rhyming, it's crazy. I find the fit of the knit on this shoe very, very accommodating. It's a little more snug than perhaps the Flyknit on the Zoomfly Flyknit. And as such, I think it's very much down to foot volume, whether this shoe's gonna work for you. It's going to be down to the shape of your foot, the volume of the foot, and that's really going to affect sizing as well. Lots of people have chimed in about odd sizing on this shoe. I find it a little snug, but not overly snug really. It's fine for me. I've gone true to size on this shoe and I've had no major issues. I think those of you who are after a more racing fit will probably want to stay true to size. Others will need to go up half a size or perhaps even a full size to get a comfortable fit. Again, we see this use of the stitched on section here on the outer side of the shoe to provide a little bit of structure. Lacing somewhat unorthodox, you've got this red kind of thick, I don't know what it's made of, it's really tough. You can't kind of bend it or move it around too much. It doesn't feel like elastic, it feels like something else, I'm not sure what it is. So those red pieces provide like a rigid anchor point for the laces to kind of grip around your foot. Warning though, the laces are stupendously long in this shoe. So how do the uppers and the midsoles on these shoes affect their performance? In fairness, I found both of these models to be relatively versatile performance shoes. Maybe not ideal for sort of super easy 9 minute per mile kind of easy runs, but for recovery paces for me, recently around 8 minutes per mile, I found these shoes work very well. But it's really for tempo runs, that interval work, that speed work, that these shoes really come into play. They both like picking up the pace and they push you to increase that cadence. The carbon plates in both of these shoes are implemented in a vastly different way. The shape of the carbon plate in the New Balance FuelCell Rebel really does prompt the runner to kind of run on that forefoot, get up onto your toes. It really does want you to do that. I wouldn't say it resists or kind of pushes against you to make you do that, but you certainly feel the propulsive nature of the shoe when you get up onto the midfoot and onto the toes. Kind of the placement of the carbon plate's a little bit different as well. It's not buried within the midsole material here. It's kind of on the outside, buried underneath this kind of translucent rubber outsole traction area. You really do start to get that spring and you pick up the pace. I felt this doing some speed work this week. The plate within the Carbon X is sandwiched in this big Pro Fly X wad of foam here. There's no real separation between the midsole and the outsole on this shoe. It's just kind of all one thing, really. I guess you could say this blue section's kind of the midsole and this is the outsole. To me, the foam feels very similar across the board. That plate's kind of forked at the end, so one side of it goes off to your big toe and the other side to the rest of your toes. This does make lots of sense to me. We naturally toe off from that big toe, so having the fork in that kind of fashion does seem to just generally make sense. It helps to prompt that action of sort of push off using the big toe. Well, I guess that plate's kind of there so that we don't bend the toes, but it certainly seems to help you to channel the toe off through your big toe. I have to say thus far that the FuelCell Rebel does feel a little bit more propulsive to me. It's quite a bit more of a minimal shoe in comparison to the Carbon X. I think that the midsole on the FuelCell Rebel is that little bit more forgiving on the foot. It's certainly softer than the ProFly X foam, but responsive enough to pick up pace. As I say, the Carbon X is initially extremely rigid, but that does seem to mellow out over time. There's a little bit of a difference weight-wise here. I started looking at some common sizes online, so US size 9 seems to be quite a common size. The Hoka coming in about 8.7 ounces, and the FuelCell Rebel was about 7.2. So there is a relatively substantial weight difference between the two, and you can feel it in hand. Certainly the Rebel is a much, much lighter shoe. It feels less kind of present underneath your foot. That aside, they're kind of aimed at different things. So FuelCell Rebel is about 1.5 ounces lighter than the Carbon X. It does feel a little bit less present on foot, but both of these shoes are seriously light, don't get me wrong. Not as feather light as the Vaporfly series, but certainly lighter than the Zoomfly 3. So what I found was that the weight increase seems more prominent as the sizes go up to that UK size 11, which I am. There was just a greater weight increase each time. The Rebel's certainly a more minimal shoe, but I think I'd probably hesitate to use it anywhere above the half marathon distance. Why, you might ask? Well, the lack of that structure and that narrower fit, I just don't think I'd really want to utilize it above a half marathon. Everybody's different though. Some people may disagree with me on that, but for me, I think that the lack of structure and the minimalist approach, I just don't think it would work for me. The Hoka Carbon X isn't quite as narrow, and it certainly feels more structured around your foot and generally more stable overall due to that slightly wider landing area here. Those aspects certainly for me make this a better shoe over a longer distance. I don't think I'd probably utilize this shoe for a 5K. I think maybe 10K and then upwards is probably the ideal placement for this shoe. Certainly half marathons, marathons, this shoe could work extremely well for you. So both these are carbon plate shoes, but they certainly have different use cases within the typical running distances. The Rebels for shorter distances at pace, and the Carbon X for those longer distances at pace. Perhaps not the same amount of pace. Who knows? Depends how fast you can run, I guess. So all in all, I think the FuelCell Rebel makes for exceptional value, really, if you can pick it up below £100. Really great shoe, very comfortable, minimal break-in required. Certainly thus far, it's worked well in a variety of conditions at a fair variety of paces. You're gonna have to shell out a bit more for the Carbon X if you can find it. It seems to be quite tough to get hold of at present. Around about £160, I think this makes for a fantastic half marathon or above shoe. It's very comfortable to me anyway. Doesn't feel that narrow. Structured and certainly forgiving if your gait cycle isn't perhaps the best. Please comment below if you own either of these shoes or you've utilized them. If you like them, if you don't like them, let me know in the comments. It would mean the world to me if you consider subscribing to the channel. Please click the subscribe button down here. Remember to give the video a thumbs up. It does make all the difference and it helps to push the videos up that ladder. Please share this video with other runners. My name's EDDBUD and I will be seeing you.